Okay, getting back to this one. Yesterday I glued his arm on, and like I've mentioned before, one of the best things you can use for uneven surfaces is just a piece of inner tube. You know, just cut a nice strip of inner tube and stretch that around there. And each time you pull it tight as you wrap it, and each time you wrap it, it just gets tighter and tighter and tighter, and it just works out great. Let me get my finger hang off here. That's on there good. And another thing, when you're gluing things, always try to orient your grain to where it's the same as the things that are being glued together. That way you get the strongest bond, and believe me, it will never come apart at the bond. If it breaks, it's going to break on either side of the bond. Okay, now let's see what else was I going to say. Anyway, what I thought we'd do in this video is I'm going to show you how to even up your shoulders to where they come into the body, which I've noticed some people have a problem with. So we'll do that, and then if we got time, we'll address the gun. But also, I want to show you this one I'm working on right now. Not sure what I'm going to call this guy, but boy, I think he just looks terrific. I love that. That is just so neat the way that's mounted. I haven't finished his hat yet, but he's going to have a Montana Peak. Love it. Okay. All righty, let me get my glove back on. Now the shoulder, it doesn't come out, well, I'm sure there are people who have shoulders that come out straight like that. But it actually slopes down. You want it to come in and mold with this part of the body, which is what we need to do. And I've left myself all kinds of material up here to allow me to do that. Another thing, see this bump right here that's on the arm? We've got to get rid of that. This is why you always leave enough extra material on your piece so you can cut it away when you're matching stuff up. Okay, it's looking better. Now let's start taking this off. There, see how your shoulder just flows right into the body now? is that stupid wasp up there. Every time the weather turns warm, my shop gets invaded with wasps. I've caulked every crack that I can find, and I still can't find out where those boogers are getting in here. Sounded like somebody was weed eating their yard there for a minute. So, I've carved one line here. I'm going to take my gouge here and just now remember what I said earlier about we line the arm up with the edge of the vest. And that's one way you hide your joint, which is what I'm going to do right now. So I'll just carve right down to that glue line. And we'll make some wrinkles on the shirt. Time.
9:30.
No, it's not 30. What's the time on the video?
9:37.
Sorry, I misunderstood. So there you can see. Just keep making these wrinkles. And it looks like that shirt is nice. I always like to take a gouge. Where is my gouge? Right there. Right back here on the elbow. Just dig in here and take a large gouge out like that. Find my knife. Where are you? And do the same thing back here on the back. just to bust up the pattern of the shirt going up over the shoulder. I want these indentations. They just make that, see the wrinkle there? See, we created. Just looks so much more realistic than just having a thing just hang straight down his arm. And it just takes a little bit to do it. See there? That looks really good. Okay. It's looking good. What's that? What? Put it back together here. Well, I got that arm on there, and it looks real slick. So now, in the upcoming video, we're going to start working on this arm. But first, set him aside. We're going to talk about that yellow boy. Get this piece out of the way. Okay, here's some lever action rifles. We've got the Winchesters, and then we have the Yellow Boy down here. Now, the Yellow Boy was the first lever-action repeater. And you can see the difference between this one and these three here is the cartridges on this one here were put in down this tube, and the cartridges on the Winchester, you could shove them in. You know, we've all seen that in the cowboy movies, or maybe we've shot a Winchester ourselves. But certainly this is much easier to do than this here, because you basically had to almost disassemble the gun to reload it. So anyway, we're going to do the Yellow Boy. And I have my Yellow Boy right here. Now the Indians came up with the name of the Yellow Boy because of the brass mechanism here. Just a beautiful gun. As you can see, I take real care of it. I've only fired it once. And again, to load this one, it's a little different than the old type. You drop your bullets down in the slot here, and they fall down in there, and depending on whether you shoot, you know, long, this is just a 22. Rather you shoot long rifles or short rifles in this case. You know how many it will hold. Now, in our, what we're going to do is he's going to be, unfortunately, he's going to be covering up almost all of the brass when he's holding his rifle. Now, I don't want to hold it like this here. I want to hold it like this here. Let me turn around and get this up and down. So what I'm going to do here in a little bit, before Judy heads back up the hill, is I'm going to have her take a bunch of photographs of me holding this rifle so I can get the hand right. It's a little different than the one we carved on the holding the lariat, because this one, the wrist is bent down like this here. So it's still a fairly relaxed hand, you know, the thing is heavy, but it's not that heavy that you're going to grip it real tight. You're just going to, you know, a guy carrying it, he's going to have it just, you know, relaxed grip on around the thing, okay? So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to cut out the blank, and we'll whittle on that to a certain point, and then we will work on the gun. Now, the gun is... comes up to my waist. It's measure out here. It's almost 40 inches, 39 or so. I might make it over here. I might make it a little longer on him.
16.
Well, that would make it on this figure. Probably around 8 to 8.5 inches. So I don't know, maybe I won't make it a little long, because it's going to be hanging down his side. J- just about like that there. So I'm going to go ahead and draw out my rifle, and in the next video we'll go ahead and carve the rifle, because I want to be able to have that rifle all finished before I start fitting it to the hand, so it fits in there real good. Okay, so until next time, I'll talk to you later.